Welcome to a lesson on multi-step conversions. In the first example, we're asked how many minutes are in a week. To answer the question, we convert 1 week to minutes. So we begin with 1 week as a fraction with a denominator of 1. And now we multiply by unit fractions to convert 1 week to minutes. Notice how there's not one conversion relating weeks to minutes, and therefore we will have to use more than one unit fraction to convert weeks to minutes. To begin, we use the conversion 1 week equals 7 days to convert weeks to days. And this one's pretty obvious, but we'll go ahead and use a unit fraction. Because we want weeks to simplify out, we must have weeks in the denominator, because right now we have weeks in the numerator. Because we're converting weeks to days, we have days in the numerator. And the conversion is 1 week equals 7 days, and therefore the unit fraction is 7 days divided by 1 week. Notice how the units of weeks simplify to 1. And now we have days, so we use a conversion 1 day equals 24 hours to convert days to hours. So we multiply by another unit fraction. We want days to simplify out, so we must have days in the denominator, which means we'll have hours in the numerator. Because 1 day equals 24 hours, the unit fraction is 24 hours divided by 1 day. The units of days simplify to 1. And now we have hours, so we'll use a conversion 1 hour equals 60 minutes to convert hours to minutes. We want hours to simplify out, so we must have hours in the denominator. The numerator will be minutes. The conversion is 1 hour equals 60 minutes, and therefore the unit fraction is 60 minutes divided by 1 hour. And again, notice how the units of hours simplify to 1. And now we multiply. Notice how the denominator is 1, and therefore the product is 7 times 24 times 60, which is equal to 10,080 minutes. So now we know there are 10,080 minutes in a week. For B, Brian needs 10 cups of fruit juice to make sangria. How many quarts of juice should he buy at the grocery store? To answer this question, we must convert 10 cups to quarts. We begin with 10 cups as a fraction with a denominator of 1. We need to multiply by unit fractions to convert cups to quarts. We are not given a conversion relating cups to quarts, and therefore we'll have to use more than one unit fraction. Because 1 pint equals 2 cups, we'll first convert cups to pints by multiplying by a unit fraction. Because we want cups to simplify out, we must have the units of cups in the denominator, and therefore we'll have pints in the numerator. And because 1 pint equals 2 cups, the unit fraction will be 1 pint divided by 2 cups. And notice how the units of cups simplify to 1. And now we have pints, so we convert pints to quarts using the conversion 1 quart equals 2 pints. We multiply by another unit fraction. We want pints to simplify out, and therefore pints must be in the denominator. And therefore we have quarts in the numerator. The conversion is 1 quart equals 2 pints, and therefore the unit fraction is 1 quart divided by 2 pints. The units of pints simplify to 1. Now we multiply. The numerator is 10, the denominator is 4, so we have 10 fourths quarts. Well, of course 10 fourths simplifies, because 10 and 4 share a common factor of 2. This simplifies to 5 halves, so we could say 5 halves quarts. Let's also convert this to a mixed number as well as a decimal. To do this, we divide, so we'd have 5 divided by 2. There are 2 twos in 5. 2 times 2 is 4. We subtract, the remainder is 1. So the quotient is 2 and 1 half, which equals 2.5. Let's go ahead and say 10 cups equals 2.5 quarts, which means Brian needs to buy 2.5 quarts of juice. I hope you found this helpful.